Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be explaining Frequency Hopping Spread Spectrum. In short, it is even referred as FHSS, Frequency Hopping Spread Spectrum. And to explain Frequency Hopping Spread Spectrum, you will see these are my session outlines where I'll explain block diagram, then modulation techniques, then how frequency hopping is happening, then difference in between frequency hopping spread spectrum and FDM, frequency division multiplexing. Then we will see slow hopping and fast hopping in FHSS. Then we will see performance of FHSS system, and then we'll sum up this session with applications of it. So let us begin this session with first point, that is block diagram. Now one can clearly see block diagram of frequency hopping spread spectrum, where this is my original information, and this original information that is been given to this modulator, or one can say spread error. So this will spread bandwidth. So original bandwidth is B and spreaded bandwidth is BSS, and this frequency hopping spread spectrum, that is analog, that is analog spread spectrum. So that one should know, frequency hopping spread spectrum is analog spread spectrum. So here original information is having bandwidth B and spreaded bandwidth is BSS, and input is original signal and frequency synthesizer signal. Now one should know this original signal that we first modulate in terms of frequency shift keying. So this original signal that is there in form of FSK. Now we'll talk about that later. So first we will be having information that we translate in FSK, and then we give it to frequency synthesizer with modulator, and then we'll be having modulated signal which is having higher bandwidth. Now how frequency is getting selected here? So that is based on PN sequence generator. So PN sequence generator will generate code, and that code will select particular carrier. Like see, if I have 3-bit code, so in 3-bit code total combinations will be, total combination that is 2 to the power 3, means total combinations are 8. So how many codes are there? 8 codes are there. Starts from 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, and 111. So this many codes are there, and as per this code, it will be selecting carrier. Let us say here carrier is F1, F2, F3, F4. Likewise, carrier will get selected based on code. So if I say right now I have PN sequence code that is this. So as per this 001 code, it will select carrier of frequency F4. So right now there will be a frequency F4. And that F4 frequency that will get modulated with respect to original signal, and that is having bandwidth BSS. So whatever code that we are selecting, based on that carrier will get selected, and that is what we give it to modulator, and you will be getting modulated output over here. And same thing that we do it at receiver side to demodulate it. So basically in frequency hopping, we will be changing frequency after some instant. So how we do frequency hopping? That we do it by changing code. So as you change the code, carrier frequency will get changed, and that carrier frequency that is been selected by this frequency synthesizer, and that will modulate this original information, and it will be resulting into modulated signal. So this is what about basic block diagram of frequency hopping spread spectrum. Now how frequency hopping is happening, so let us try to understand that. So for that I have made this basic diagram. Now see, here I have one cycle and this is my second cycle. So this is cycle 1 and this is cycle 2. Now see, in one cycle, for first instant, for one cycle, for first instant, it will be selecting one frequency. So if I say for first instant, it is selecting F6 based on some code. Like if code is 101, first frequency will be F6. So first frequency will be F6. Now if second code is 001, then second frequency will be F2. So this is F2. So for second instant, this frequency will get selected. For third instant, if I say frequency is F3 by code 010, so for third instant, it is F3 010. For fourth instant, if I say for fourth instant, it is 000F1, so it will be this for fourth instant. For fifth instant, if it is 111, then it will select F8 over here. For next instant, it may select this. For next instant, it may select this. And for next instant, it may select this. So this is how one can see with respect to time, this frequency is getting changed. Right. So with respect to time, for one cycle, frequencies are different for a different instant. And this is what we repeat for second cycle. So as you can see, for first instant in second cycle, it will be this. Then for next instant, it will be this. For next, it will be this. And that is how we select different instants. And we send different frequency at different instant. It means we are changing frequency with respect to time. So frequency hopping is what? Changing frequency with respect to time. So that is what frequency hopping, and that is how we do it. Now let us move on to next portion, that is modulation techniques. So see, there are effective digital modulation methods like PSK, phase shifting, QAM, quadrature amplitude modulation, PAM, pulse amplitude modulation. But why do we select FSK? The reason is, when you talk about these effective methods like PSK, QAM, PAM, these methods are not effective in coherent detection. So in coherent detection, these methods are costly, and because of these methods are so costly, for coherent detection, we cannot go for PSK, QAM and PAM. So for coherent detection, it is easier to have FSK, frequency shift keying. And that's why you can see earlier I have told, in log diagram, original signal will get translated into FSK and then we give it to spreader. So modulation technique in frequency hopping is FSK. So this should be preferred in FHSS. So that is where it is effective. Now let us have difference in between frequency hopping spread spectrum and FDM. Now see here, FDM is there. So with respect to time, how frequency is getting selected, that is what I will be explaining here. So in frequency division multiplexing, channel will not change frequency. So if I say this is channel 1, so channel 1 will not change frequency with respect to time. If I say this is channel 2, so channel 2 will not change frequency with respect to time. If I say this is channel 3, so it will not change frequency with respect to time. And if I say channel 4 is there over here, so it will not change frequency with respect to time. But in FHSS, it is possible frequency will get changed with respect to time. Like see, here channel 1 is there, over here channel 1 is this, over here channel 1 is this, and over here channel 1 is this. So with respect to time, channel 1 is changing. Channel 2, that is even getting changed. Like channel 2 is over here, channel 2 is over here, channel 2 is over here, like this. Channel 3, so it may be channel 3 over here, channel 3 may be over here, channel 3 may be over here, channel 3 over here, and channel 3 over here and channel 3 over here and channel 4. So you can see channel 4 is changing frequency with respect to time. So as all channels are changing frequency with respect to time, it is called as frequency hopping spread spectrum. So in FHSS, frequency changes with respect to time, while in FDM, frequency does not change with respect to time for different channels. So this is how it is different. Now, what is the meaning of fast hopping and slow hopping? So fast hopping means what and slow hopping means what? So for that we need to understand what is TC and what is TB. So TB is bit period and TC is chip period. So here you can see this is cycle 1 period, that is chip period. So if your bit period is greater than chip period, then one can say this is fast hopping. And if chip period is greater than bit period, then that will be slow hopping. So based on duration of chip period and bit period, whether it is fast hopping or slow hopping, that we can understand. And usually we should know we have always prefer fast hopping. So this is what we should prefer. Now let us have a basic analysis of FHSS for its performance. So performance that we identify based on signal to interference ratio, SIR, signal to interference ratio, and that we can calculate by bandwidth divided by M minus 1 into log of base 2 L divided by L into RB. And here B is system bandwidth . M is number of user . L is number of orthogonal code and RB is bit rate, or one can say signaling rate. So by this formula we can have analysis of FHSS frequency hopping spread spectrum. And let us have few applications to sum up this session. So basically you will be observing this frequency hopping spread spectrum that has been utilized in Bluetooth. And when you use Bluetooth, you will be finding in a second 625 times frequency hopes. Means in 1 second 625 times frequency changes. So Bluetooth is very popular method for this application of FHSS. And one more application that you can see, that is JTRS. J stands for Joint Tactical Radio System. So these are so popular methods which is there with FHSS, and that is where it is applicable. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. In next session, I'll explain DSSS that has been utilized in digital system, that is even having some importance. So we will see that in next session. I hope that you have understood this right now. I'll explain this basics of spread spectrum for digital system using DSSS in next session. Thank you so much for watching this video.